Hey all, welcome to my Puerto Rico wrap-up video. I'm gonna tell you all about this beautiful island. I spent 1 month there. I'll share the things that I liked, I'll share the things that I didn't really like that much, but I'll start with a little bit of wrap-up and tell you where I went, what I've seen, and who I met. I based myself in San Juan in a hostel where I volunteered for 3 days a week. I lived with 5 other girls and a couple of them are one of my favorite people now. I took the advantage of 4 days off every week and traveled around the island as much as I could. I visited 2 different islands and the national park and did a road trip, which was fun. When I could not find anybody to do fun trips with, I enjoyed walking around the capital, visiting its museums, learning about the rich history of Puerto Rico, and just appreciating the old San Juan. And yeah, let's not forget about the crazy fun parties that I went to.
Oh my god!
I knew it. Here are the reasons why I fell in love with Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico is full of beautiful beaches and forests. 2 of my favorite places were Flamenco Beach on this island called Culebra, which means a snake, by the way, and El Yunque National Park. Flamenco Beach was named one of the top 10 most beautiful beaches in the world, and I can see why. Because Puerto Rico is a small island, you do not need to travel for endless hours to reach one place to another, which I always appreciate. In my first video about Puerto Rico, I tried to explain that I connect to the people's struggles here on another level because I know what it feels like to be from a small country and to fight for your independence and your culture in general. Boricuas are very proud of their culture. They want to keep the traditions going, which is understandable. Because of the poor economy, a lot of Puerto Ricanos have to go to the United States to find decent jobs. Meanwhile, foreigners are moving to fancier places, living their best lives closer to crystal clear beaches in Puerto Rico. So all I'm trying to say is that it was easier to relate to the culture that faces more or less the same problems as mine. Puerto Rican people know how to set themselves free through movement and music. It amazed me that in some places like Bonanza, for example, people of all ages come to dance together. I've seen a 60-year-old dancing with a young hippie covered in tattoos, a nurse in his uniform moving his hips on salsa, and a gringo dancing on bomba with a beautiful Puerto Ricana. In most places they play reggaeton, which makes sense because the most popular reggaeton artists like Daddy Yankee or Bad Bunny are Puerto Ricanos. To be totally honest with you, I'm not a big fan of reggaeton, especially if the lyrics are extremely disrespectful toward women. But to see these people having a tremendous amount of fun when dancing to reggaeton made me very happy. They are very proud of this type of music and it makes them dance happily till the sunrise. What can be better than that? Oh, and please comment down if you have a favorite reggaeton song. I'm really interested.
Mofongo!
Mofongo!
And now here are the things that I didn't really like. I know, Boricuas are very welcoming people. They have big hearts, I could feel that, especially on my road trip. People in the villages were very nice and more hospitable than in San Juan. Locals in the capital city seem to be a little bit overwhelmed by the gringos who moved to Puerto Rico. Well, I look very white and sometimes they assumed I was from one of the privileged countries. So sometimes I felt like I was not welcomed in a few places. For example, one day I went dancing to bomba music when somebody came to me and asked me to stop dancing because the song was rebellious and revolutionary. I do understand their point though, and I met a few gringos living on the island and asked them if they felt unwelcome. All of them said yes, but their answer basically was something like, haters gonna hate. But it's so much more than that. That's when you know they don't empathize with the people and have no idea what they are doing by moving to another country. But on the other hand, I do not want to judge people who seek a better place to live or a better life in general. So I don't know, it's complicated. Let me know if you have an opinion. Because Puerto Rico is an island, everything is imported except for few local goods that they produce on the island, like coffee, for example. And again, because it's a part of the US, everything goes through the US regulations, and sometimes some items arrive on the East Coast first, like New York or Florida, and then to Puerto Rico. So as you can imagine, this whole process makes everything very expensive. On top of that, many hurricanes and floodings are happening that destroy tons of crops and leave people without electricity or anything. So what I'm trying to say is that the island is not a cheap backpacking destination, which I already knew, but I did not expect it to be that expensive. I said this in a Puerto Rico travel Facebook group and some people disagreed. For Americans and Canadians, it might not be as expensive to spend a holiday there, but for backpackers, it is. And Puerto Rico is objectively one of the most expensive Caribbean islands. Even buying food in a supermarket and cooking was pricey. Luckily, I had a free accommodation and I love to walk, so I didn't spend much money on taxis. There's probably one or two buses that commute around San Juan and you always have to pay the exact amount of cash. I couldn't find a bus that would go from San Juan to another big city simply because there isn't a system of buses or trains that runs around Puerto Rico. That's horrible for me as a backpacker because I mostly rely on buses and trains when I visit other countries. So if you want to visit literally anything in Puerto Rico, you have to either rent a car or make friends with people who have cars. A couple of times we asked Carlos, our host, to drive us to the places, even though we shared the gas and tried to reciprocate with some food or drinks. I still felt like he was doing us a huge favor. And finally, the reason why I think I would never go back to the island is that I think I've seen enough. And 1 month is more than enough time to explore the island. I'm thankful for the piña colada, mofongo, playa flamenco, el yunque, the people I met there, and the fun nights out, that's for sure. Do you know what I noticed? Latinos who work in the US find Puerto Rico the best place to live because it reminds them of home a little bit and they can continue working freely. It hits differently for them, the food, the people, the culture, parties, music, everything. I'm glad I did this trip and I would choose to go there over and over and over again. However, I didn't feel this magical connection that I sometimes feel with the places. The one I felt on the Camino, for example, or in San Cristobal de las Casas in Mexico. And so that's why I will probably never go back, and that's absolutely fine. Gracias, Puerto Rico, for having me, and I wish your people the life they really deserve. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.